Awliya Allah, you've seen the chadar of Ghawsi Azam Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani. This is not a normal chadar. It has the nisbat of Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani. I read a story from the life of Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala. During his time, there was a fire. The fire was burning, destroying villages. Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala said to Abu Musa Ashari, he says, go and show my mantle to the fire. Go and show my chadar to the fire. As soon as he did that, the fire died down.
Subhanallah, subhanallah.
The point is, this is written in the books of history. This is one of the miracles of Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala. Now the question is, had Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala who stood in front of the fire, we would understand. Because he is Waliullah. And the nature of the fire is to burn. But the fire saw the nisbat of Umar radiallahu ta'ala. The fire did not see Umar radiallahu ta'ala. The fire saw the chadar of Umar radiallahu ta'ala. This chadar is not a normal chadar. This is not something that you buy in shops and businesses. This has the nisbat of he who is the blood of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Nisbat. Nisbat is important. Nisbat, association, relationship. Hazrat Abdul Rahman Safuri, he mentions that walking towards Madinatul Munawwara is more superior to walking towards Makkatul Mukarrama. Why? Walking towards Medina is more afzal, is more superior, is more beneficial than walking towards Makkah. They asked him, why are you saying? He says, لِيَنَّ الْبُقْعَةَ أَلَّتِي تَمَّتْ آدَاهُ الشَّرِيفَةُ الْأَبْدَلُ مِنَ الْعَرْشُ وَالْكُرْسِ.
Subhanallah, subhanallah.
The spot, the soil which is touching the body of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is more superior to Arsh and Kursi. It's more superior to Arsh and Kursi. This is why the Sufiya and the Awliya say, if the soil which is touching the body of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is more superior to Arsh and Kursi, then imagine and tell me the status of Fatima al-Zahra, Imam Hassan and Imam Hussein, was the blood of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Nisbat. Nisbat. Which city is more superior? Makkah or Medina? People say, Makkah, more beneficial. One good deed is 100,000. And Madinatul Munawwara one is 50,000. So if me and Maulana Musa are sitting next to me, if he gives you 100,000 rand per man, and I give you 50,000, who would you go to? I ask the businessman. You'll go to Maulana Musa. He's more beneficial. He's a better bank than I am. Yeah? Yeah? But I tell you what's more beneficial. In Makkatul Mukarrama, if you make one mistake, how much? 100,000. And in Madinatul Munawwara, one is one. One is one. And the Sufiya and the Awliya say, even if that one remains because of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he is Shafi'ul Muslimin. It's a hadith of Rasulullah al-Mustafa al-Bazzar. And if you read other books of hadith, it's a hadith of Rasulullah, Hayati khairun lakum, my life is good for you. Wa mamati khairun lakum, even my death is good for you. Tu'radu alayya amalukum, your actions, your amal will be presented to me in my grave. In ra'itu khairan hamidullaha, if I see that your amal are good, I will praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I will praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if I see that your amal and your actions are not good, I will ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness on your behalf. On your behalf. Nisbat. Nisbat. You know, there was a discussion between Imam Abu Hanifa, Imam Shafi, Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal, Imam Malik. They said, Makkatul Mukarrama, the three Aima said, Makkatul Mukarrama. Mukarram, my superior. Imam Malik says, no. No. Before Hijrat, Makkah was superior. After Hijrat, Medina is superior. After Hijrat, Medina is superior because of the relationship and its association with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Pick the books of history and read. Medina was Yathrib. Medina was a place where diseases used to take place and occur. New diseases. But the presence of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was so powerful, was so strong, was so influential that the dust of Medina has become into Shifa.
SubhanAllah!
Nisbat. What is Qadri? Nisbat. Chishti. Nisbat. Naqshbandi. Nisbat. Suharwardi. Nisbat. Rifai. Nisbat. Shazili. Nisbat. When you are holding the hand of your Shaykh, you are holding his hand. In fact, you are holding the hand of Shaykh Abdul Qadir Jilani.
Nisbat.
We were in Jeddah with His Eminence, and there was a man who came, and he says, what is this Qadri, Naqshbandi, Suhrawardi, Shazili, Rifai, Chishti, Barakati, what is all this? He said, mention in Quran and Hadith. I said, my friend, what are you? He says, I'm Saudi. I said, is it mentioned in Quran and Hadith? For you, I said, for you, the nisbat of Ibn Saud is important. For me, the nisbat of Muinuddin Chishti is important. Ghawsi Azam Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani is important. Data Ganj Bakshali Hajmeri is important. Nizamuddin Awliya is important. That is your passport on the Day of Judgment. Qadri is my passport on the Day of Judgment. Nisbat, being the lovers of the awliya and the sufiya, and these are not normal people. La khawfun alayhim wa la hum yahzanun. Quran says they have no fear. They have absolutely no fear. Last point, and inshallah, I'm just going to close this, and then we move on to eating some delicious biryani, inshallah. And I can see a lot of smiling faces. Alhamdulillah. Hazrat Maqdoom Ashraf Jahangir Samnani. And his nephew Hazrat Abdul Razak Murunay, and they are both buried next to each other. He Hazrat Abdul Razak Murunay used to like chemistry. Hazrat Maqdoom Ashraf Jahangir Samnani once called his nephew. He says, Abdul Razak, come here. He says, bring me a stone. He brought him a stone, and as soon as Hazrat Maqdoom Ashraf Jahangir Samnani touched the stone, it turned into gold. This is written in the Taif Ashraf. He says, Abdul Razak, I'm not asking you to bring me a piece of gold, bring me a stone. He brought him a stone again. It turned into gold again. He says, Abdul Razak, what are you doing? Bring me a stone. Abdul Razak Nurulain brought him a stone again, it turned into gold. He says, Hazrat, I'm bringing you a stone, it's turning into gold. He says, Abdul Razak, why don't you learn this chemistry? Why don't you learn this chemistry? La khawf. Can poverty fear them? Hazrat Nizamuddin Awliya, someone came to him. Hazrat, I'm very poor. He read Surah Al-Ikhlas 11 times on a stone, turned it to gold, he says, go, sell it. That man thought, mashallah, I've got the formula now. And what he did is, he bought the stones for Delhi in his house, and all night Surah Al-Ikhlas. All night Surah Al-Ikhlas. Stone was stone. He went next day to Hazrat Nizamuddin Awliya. He says, Hazrat, I read Surah Ikhlas all night. You read only 11 times. I was reading. Hazrat Nizamuddin Awliya says, innocent man, you have the formula, but where are you going to bring the breath of Nizamuddin? They have no fear, inshallah. Alhamdulillah, in my point on one of the important incidents that happened in the life of Hazrat Jalaluddin Rumi, who is, according to me, one of the masters of Turkey, alhamdulillah, and one of the greatest Sufis to have represented Islam. He says he was an outstanding scholar. He didn't believe in all the tasawwuf and all that until he met Shams Qamar. He writes that I heard, and this is an incident that our elders from our family told us, so I just wanted to show you. He writes that, I heard that Shams Tabrizi came in the town. So I went to see him. And I saw that his door, there was a security. And he read one line. He says, Zare Durvesh La Tarbaat Baya. He says, what kind of a Durvesh is he? Who's got security on his door? You know, what kind of a weak man this guy is? Who's got security on his door? He left. And then he slept at night time and he saw a dream that he is studying and Hazrat Shams Tabrizi is coming in his dream. And Hazrat Shams Tabrizi asks, Maulana, what are you doing? What is these books? And Maulana Jalaluddin Rumi in his dream, he says, He says, this is that knowledge which you have no knowledge of. These are books, these are ahadith, these are tafsir, this is fiqh. And you're a Sufi, what knowledge do you have? Hazrat Shams Tabrizi said, acha. He picked up his book and threw it in water. Hazrat Jalaluddin Rumi was angry. He said, what have you done? What have you done? And he picked up the book and he gave it to Jalaluddin Rumi. And the effect of water was not on the book. The effect of the water was not on the book. Jalaluddin Rumi asked, E cheese, what is this? He says, E razes ke tu namita. He says, this is that secret which you have no knowledge of. Alhamdulillah, he woke up in the morning and Alhamdulillah, his eyes were open. He went to the khanqah of Hazrat Shams Tabriz. He saw security again. But he did not say anything this time. He went in. He met Hazrat Shams Tabriz. And Hazrat Shams Tabriz says to him, Maulana, you came yesterday. What was that one liner you gave me? Subhanallah. What was that one line poetry you gave me? He says, no, 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 Hazrat, I don't want to say. He says, no, no, say. He says, Ture Turvesh Ra Tarbaat Baya. He says, Maulana, add another line. Pabaya Ta Sake Dunya Naya.
Subhanallah.
Add another line. That a Turvesh does not need security, but sometimes the security is required so the dogs of this world cannot enter the heart. Alhamdulillah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the tawfiq to follow Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as he should be followed. To love Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as he should be loved.
मेरे रसूल पाक के गुलशन के चार फूल हैं। हजरते फातिमा ज़हरा,
वाह वाह,
हजरते अली इमाम हसन,
हक है
मेरे रसूल पाक के गुलशन के चार फूल हैं, नूरे मोहम्मदी की है, नूरे मोहम्मदी की है, सब में झलक مظہر رسول ہے اور کوئی ہم شبیہ رسول ہے نور محمدی کی ہے سب میں جھلک الگ ہے
بہت خوب
دوستوں آئیے ہم سب مل کے درود پاک نہ جانا پیش کریں میں دراصل اکثر انگریزی میں خطاب کرتا ہوں اس میدان کا نیا کھلاڑی ہوں اردو میں تو آپ ہر سال سنتے رہتے ہیں انگریزی بیچ بیچ میں گلوکوز دیتا رہوں گا
کیا سبحان اللہ
اب ایسا تھا کہ کچھ اولیاء اللہ کا ذکر ہو جائے اس کے بعد پھر شیخ طریقت ذکر بھی کرائیں گے
کیا سبحان اللہ
ان کا ذکر جو ہے حضرت سفیان بن عیانہ فرماتے ہیں کہ عند ذکر صالحین تنزل الرحمہ جہاں جہاں اولیاء اور صالحین کا ذکر ہوتا ہے وہاں رحمت برستی ہے
سبحان اللہ
جن کے ذکر سے رحمت برستی ہے وہ جہاں ہوں
کیا سبحان اللہ
وہ جہاں ہوں
بہت ہو
تو دوستوں اسی لیے اجمیر اجمیر تھا لیکن جب غریب نواز پہنچ گئے تو اجمیر شریف ہو
گئے
کچوچھا کچوچھا تھا لیکن جب مخدوم سمنانی پہنچ گئے تو کچوچھا شریف ہو گئے میں کے لیے جاتا ہوں ساؤتھ افریقہ ہے لیزبن پورچگل بڑی کامیابی کی بات چلتی ہے ہم کامیاب ہیں وہ کہتے ہیں مغربی دنیا ہم کامیاب ہیں آج چاہے ہم ہو آپ ہو کامیابی چاہتے ہیں انجینئر کامیابی ڈاکٹر ہو کامیابی عالم ہو کامیابی مقرر ہو کامیابی نعت پڑھتا ہے کامیابی سب کامیابی چاہیے اور صوفیہ کیا فرماتے ہیں کہ کامیابی اگر تم کو چاہیے تو وہ کامیابی قدم رسول میں ملے گی
سبحان اللہ سبحان اللہ
سبحان اللہ
حق ہے اور یہ میں کوئی لفاظی بات نہیں کرتا آپ مغربی دنیا میں دیکھیے وہ کہتے ہیں کہ ہم کامیاب ہمیں کامیابی حاصل ہے ہم نے یہ بنایا ہے وہ ٹیکنالوجی ہماری ہے یہ ٹیکنالوجی ہماری ہے ہم نے چاند تک کا سفر کیا لیکن دوستو صوفیہ فرماتے ہیں کہ یہ کامیابی نہیں ہے کامیابی تو یہ ہے کہ اس کے پیر کی دھول کو چومنا جس کے ایک اشارے سے چاند کے دو ٹکڑے ہو ایک بوڑھی ماں اپنے بچے کو لے جاتی ہے ڈاکٹر کے پاس کہ ڈاکٹر میرا بچہ 8 سال کا ہو گیا ہے یہ بولتا ہی نہیں کوئی لفظ نہیں بولتا ڈاکٹر نے کہا کہ بلڈ ٹیسٹ کراؤ ایکس رے کراؤ کبھی یہ کراؤ کبھی وہ کراؤ کبھی یہاں جاؤ کبھی وہاں جاؤ پھر آخری میں کہتا ہے کہ تیرا بچہ بول نہیں سکتا اس لیے کہ پیدائشی گونگا ہے کتاب الشفا اٹھا کے دیکھو قاضی ایاز اس قصے کی روایت کرتے ہیں کہ ایک بوڑھی ماں رسول اللہ صلی اللہ تعالی علیہ وسلم کی بارگاہ میں آئی یا رسول اللہ میرا بچہ 8 سال کا ہو گیا ہے بولتا نہیں ہے تو کہا اچھا بچے ادھر آؤ من آنا بتا میں کون ہوں بچے نے کہا رسول اللہ صلی اللہ تعالی علیہ وسلم وہ یہ ہے کہ جب رسول اللہ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم نے کہا منانا اس میں سوال ہے کہ تو بتا بچے سے نہیں کہا اس کی گونگی زبان سے کہا کہ تو بتا میں کون ہوں وہ فرماتے ہیں کہ جب کنکڑی بول اٹھی تو زبان کیوں نہ بولتی کچھ لوگ آئے کہا کامیابی جو ہے وہ اہدنا صراط المستقیم ہے اب یہ تو ہے ہم بھی مانتے ہیں لیکن اہدنا صراط المستقیم ہے کیا یہ جو سیدھا راستہ ہے یہ کیا ہے آئیے سید المفسرین کی بارگاہ हजरत अब्दुल्लाह इब्ने अब्बास से किसी ने पूछा, ये सिराते मुस्तकीम क्या है, आप बताइए कि सिराते मुस्तकीम क्या है? तो फरमाते हैं कि सिराते मुस्तकीम यानी रहमतुल लिल आलमीन मोहम्मद रसूलुल्लाह सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम। सीधा रास्ता जो है मेरे दोस्तों, कामयाबी रसूल के कदमों में, इसीलिए सिद्दीक अकबर कामयाब, फारूक आजम कामयाब, उस्मान अज़ीम कामयाब, मौला अली कामयाब।